Thank you so much. So by qualification, I'm an undergraduate and an MBA. But I guess it's a world of colors and art, which really, you know, got my attention. And I finally seem to have found my place. I guess growing up, you know, with a father who's an architect and an artist, so I was just naturally drawn with a subject. And eventually, after having worked in the public sector, I have found my calling, and I guess this is it. So, what I have here are two of my artworks, and both pretty close to my heart. This one especially, because this, like I was sharing earlier, is kind of a call out to one of my childhood dreams of wanting to be an archaeologist. And this is something which is the closest I've ever come to it.
And so basically, what we try to express in your art.
So I call my, my work is like my life's journey. If, you know, when you look at my work, you will be able to probably figure out where I am in life, what I'm thinking about, or what I'm going through. Because for me, it's an outpouring of, my thoughts and my emotions at that given point in time. So, like I said, this is something about, some aspirations that I had growing up and how I wanted to connect the past with the present. You know, when we talk about the ruins usually are, taken in the context of something which is forgotten, which is relegated to the back. But to connect it to, elements which are alive, I think it just shows the connect between how we are connected with our past, and if you not take it apart, and to keep that connect going. So for me, this particular artwork, ties me closer, gets me closer to my heritage, my tradition, and my culture. So that is why it's really, really close to my heart. This other one, essentially, is one of my very favorite themes, the equation, of course, because I just find that I'm such a beautiful being, full of strength, yet grace and gentleness. The eyes, actually, if you look at the horse, when you look at their eyes, they communicate so much. And I believe that is true for most beings, because, when a person looks at the eyes, they know what they're thinking or what they're thinking. So, like I said, my work is my journal. So this was during the time when there was a lot of turmoil, going through a phase. So this was, post COVID, but just after COVID period and post that. So there were a lot of introspection going on. There is a lot of, you're trying to, sort things out, figure things out. So this painting, while it's small in size, but it took immense time. It was created over a period of time for me, 4 months. I shared it, came back to it, left it again. So the colors there for me also are very important, because I didn't think of using those particular colors. They just came to me randomly. I just happened to be, I just got pulled, drawn towards them. And it was the background which came first, and the horse entered later, because I just couldn't feel, it being complete without that being there. Maybe it was, calling out. When I look at it, some people might find it looking like a little sad. But for me, it was more introspective, the expression or the emotion which I think I was going through was, looking inward and trying to look for something, reaching out, when looking through, so the light.
It's the forward and giving clarity of hope.
Absolutely. So there's a lot of introspection going on, and the strength. And to carry through every stage in life, whatever challenges you're throwing, that is what you do. So the grace to accept that, and that strength to move forward, that is why the MVP, I think it just died back, and it just came so randomly and fluidly. Just, so I guess that whole aspect of it is what, again, makes it special.
So I think we are short of time, and you are. So you are present at the day of opening inauguration.
Yes.
Just tell me something about your experience.
So I think my association with Kunal is very recent, but I think it's been a beautiful experience. We were just telling Smita also that it's such a wonderfully curated event. And you know, to make every artist feel so comfortable and take care of every little aspect is something I think it's a really big positive. So I look forward to a continued association with Kunal. I wish you all the best. Beautifully set up and each and everything taken, thought of. So, my congratulations for the beautiful, beautiful exhibition.
Same for you. It's a pleasure to have you as an artist in this exhibition. So we wish you all the best for your future and the future of arts. Good luck. Yeah.